Hey guys, this is Fei Wu from Fei's World Media, and this is the video we've all been waiting for. In this video, I'm going to teach you step by step. The whole thing is going to take 15 minutes or less, so that when you're teaching your dance lessons, your fitness classes to your students on Zoom, you're able to connect your microphone along with music on Spotify or iTunes or wherever of your choice. Now, I will say that this solution is for Mac users only. I'm sorry to you Windows users. I am in the middle of researching other solutions, and please stay on this channel and I'll do my best to let you know what my research is going to show us and tell us. The software I'll be introducing along with this video is called Loopback. Now, Loopback comes with a trial, 20 minutes, which is enough for you to test out whether it's going to work for you or not. Now, if you love what you see, then to purchase a full version of the software, it's $99. I know it's a lot of money. I was also hoping for it to be cheaper. However, it is going to be a one-time payment. So think about it. If you're already paying $15 per month for Zoom, that's a subscription. But for Loopback, you only need to pay for it once. Loopback is going to help you overcome the constraint of Zoom, which is Zoom only allows one audio input and output. And Loopback is going to give the opportunity to combine your microphone with Spotify or whatever the music player into your output channel. So that when you go back to Zoom and when you select advanced option and computer audio only, and that computer audio only is going to combine your microphone and your Spotify to transmit to your students who are learning from you on Zoom. I am so excited about this. Definitely come check it out. First, you need to download the app from a company called Rogue. I think it's called Amoeba, and it's called Loopback. But even if you just search for this company right here and just go to their website, which I'm going to include in the link below, the app you need is called Loopback. Now, once you click on that, there is a free download. So now I just downloaded this and it says double click on it. This download serves as both a free trial and the full version of the software. Unlock the full version simply by entering a license key. Now I'm going to install the software. Double click on that. Choose install. So now once you log into Loopback, I'm going to show you step by step how you connect your AirPods, your Spotify, and then transmit that combined sound into Zoom and then send it directly to your students, to your dancers. Now, the good news I will preface by saying you're able to control the volume for both. It requires some testing at home, means you can control the volume through Spotify. You can also control your speaking volume inside AirPods. Now, what's really amazing about the software Loopback is that it gives you the monitors option right here without you having to run back and forth between your computer and a pretend or test computer to see what the volume is like. You're able to listen to that directly through your AirPods. So let's get started. First, let me explain the very simple components on this page. Number one, it says Loopback Audio. This is just a title. So let's just call you Jane. So Jane's AirPods and Spotify. That's it. So we're combining your AirPods, your speaking, with Spotify, its music. Now, you can also use iTunes and there are a bunch of other sources, but let me help you understand the mechanics or the anatomy of this application. Number one, you have sources, where the music is coming from. Then in the middle column right here, you have your output channels. Very simple. This is where you're sending and combining the music channels. Lastly, there's monitors. Monitors, totally optional. This is for you to hear and test to see what the sound will be like for your dancers, for your students. So to monitor, you can easily monitor using your AirPods, because remember, AirPods allows you to listen as well to send your voices as well. So it's kind of a listening and a speaking tool. So let's get started. Step one, the pass-through module. You do not need this. You can either turn it off, or I would recommend just get rid of it. So highlight this box in green, go down here and click on delete.
Now you can build everything from scratch. Check it out. Step one is that you want to plug in your AirPods. Now, if you haven't done that through your iMac or your desktop, you have to, number one, make sure you enable Bluetooth, and then you can connect the device and you put it in. So that's step one. Now, once your AirPods are connected, you need to add it as a source. So click on the plus sign here and select AirPods. Now, note it, it's underneath a category called audio devices. You're not going to see it at the very top. Underneath devices, select your AirPods, not phase AirPods. Done. Take a look at under options. You click on options, and this dropdown is where you can adjust the volume. And this becomes very handy once you intertwine that with Spotify. Next is you add either Spotify or your iTunes, whatever you choose to play your music. So this is Apple Music, for example. I personally like to use Spotify. To verify that both AirPods on, Spotify on, and now these channels are traveling through what's called output channels, left and right. And you're done on this page, basically. So if you want to monitor it and to make sure that it sounds right, I would recommend that you do that through monitors. So click on monitors. Again, you're doing it through your AirPods. So do that. Verify that it's on. Through your AirPods, you're able to hear both the left and the right channels. Okay, now inside of Zoom, everything is the same as what we talked about in the first video, which is teach dance on Zoom. What you need to do, click on the green button that says share screen, go up to advanced, then click computer sound only. Now click on share to confirm the setting. The only nuance to all of this is that you just created a new microphone channel that is Jane's AirPods and Spotify. Now you're able to find that inside your Zoom. So let me show you where that is. Once you're in Zoom, click on the up arrow to the right of the mute button. You see under select microphone, now you have Jane's AirPods and Spotify. You are done. Now you're able to teach your students with not only a mic on, but your hands free. You can dance, you can exercise. So let me explain real quick. What does it mean by computer audio only? That is transmitting the computer sound to the output channels. But what is the output channels now? It's not just Spotify. It is now combined my AirPods and Spotify, or maybe in your case, your AirPods and then your iTunes music. So that's it. All right, Faye editing here. I want to also show you guys what it means to be able to adjust volumes for your devices. So check it out. Inside Loopback right now, once I click on the arrow next to options, I can control the volume of my AirPods like this. And my AirPods are disconnected, by the way. In order to really run this correctly, you have to make sure that, you know, your AirPods stay in your ear, your Bluetooth is turned on. But once you do that, you're able to control the volume. Same thing for Spotify or for iTunes or Apple Music. You're able to adjust the music here. So that's quite convenient, actually, because you're able to, for example, turn down your music and then turn up your AirPods so that when you're speaking, your students can hear you clearly. In other words, I see jazz musicians and dancers will be able to, for example, teach their students with Spotify's volume full on while their voice is also at 100%, or when they're explaining the steps during the teaching phase, they're able to turn down the music and then keep their voice up. So you can still hear the music in the background, but you hear their voice penetrating through more. So I hope this helps.
If you haven't met me, my name is Fei Wu, and I run this channel called Fei's World Media. You might not know this, but I've been a podcaster for 5 years and a filmmaker for the past couple of years. And I started this channel in October 2019. I am so thrilled to be connecting with so many of you in the past week during such a short period of time. And I just want to say that this is what I can do to kind of help you get through this crisis. I'm here to support independent creators, creative entrepreneurs, because I love you and I love what you do. And I want to share with you the tips, tools, and tutorials, such as live streaming from Zoom and other channels and sources as well. And beyond that, I want to show you how to make a living doing what you do and to celebrate both your creative and financial freedom.
Hey, Faye Editing here. I forgot to mention that I started a Facebook group called Dan's Livestream and Videos. So I welcome if you're an instructor or a student to come check it out. I'll be connecting people who are doing this during this crisis, as well as people who are craving to join your classes. I already have so many instructors offering amazing lessons, live streaming right from the living room. So I welcome you to join me. And you can also reach me via email. I left my contact information below. Thank you for being amazing. Let me know if there's anything I can help you out with. I am, again, not an expert, so I'm doing a lot of research out of love for dance instructors. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video.
If you haven't subscribed, please consider doing so right now, and I'll see you very soon. Thank you.